Hi, everybody, and away we go with another edition of the Stampede Wrestling Show. That's how it was for decades on television. Stampede Wrestling, a show that I think wore the title of excellence and certainly goes a way back in time. I'm Ed Whalen. I had the privilege to be involved from year one on television, but Stampede Wrestling went back even further, back to 1948, when Stu Hart, who had a wonderful reputation in the ring, went into promotion in Calgary, and he brought in some great stars like Earl McCready and Al Mills, and I think of Gorgeous George and Lou Thesz, some of the great wrestlers of that era. And throughout the years, Stu and Company had this tradition of excellence that made it a show that went far beyond the confines of merely Calgary, across the country, and indeed around the world, to the applause of wrestling fans everywhere. Back to 1948. Now we move ahead, fast forward to 1956, and that's when the show hit the television airwaves. It stayed there for 35 years, 35 exciting years. And there was a level of excellence. There was a fury of competition. There was an atmosphere in an old building in Calgary called the Pavilion, which was really kind of a stock pavilion, but it had an atmosphere that I thought lent itself to an intimacy, to an excitement that made Stampede Wrestling the show that it became. Boy, did I enjoy those nights when we went through the taping of these particular productions, and indeed, I should know because I was there for decades. Now, in this show, it is totally impossible, of course, to graphically illustrate for you all of the stars of Stampede Wrestling and all of the excitement. But we have tried to pull out of our vast storeroom of shows of yesteryear some of the great classic matches and some of the names of wrestling that I'm sure remain imprinted on the international scene now and probably forever. The caliber, the excellence, simply outstanding. You know what we're going to do? Bout number one, we're going to take a look at a great rivalry that I thought reached really epic proportions. I'm talking about the celebrated Dan Crawford, and I'm talking about the legendary Stomper, Archie Goldie. There's a rivalry that I thought knew no bounds, and it added up to sheer excitement in the ring. All right, here they are, battling for the North American title. I want you to fasten your seat belts, because this one's a ring-a-ding-dong dandy.
The North American Heavyweight Championship on the line. Champion Dan Crawford, challenger the Stomper. We pick up the action. It's all square apiece. And Crawford has this place in an absolute uproar. Referee is Bob Frank, the winner of this match. On Sunday night, and this applies only to Calgary, on Sunday night, will face Harley Race for the world title. Stomper taking a little siesta. Stomper gave Crawford an awesome pounding, won the first fall. Lately, Crawford has come back strong. Got him with a sleeper just a few minutes ago, and it's all squared one fall apiece, and Dan Crawford continues to hold a big advantage. You could say the Stomper's just hanging around. Boy, he's just hanging on right now. Crawford. Crawford is the man who defeated the Stomper for the North American title. But look out, this guy isn't through yet. time limit. Oh, a good right hand. This has been a great fight. Crowd is yelling, get him the sleeper. Beautifully timed drop kick. Crawford hit him on the head. Now the stopper gets up and goes to work with a boot. Well, what do you know? One, two, three, and this crowd is angry. This crowd is really angry.
I just don't believe it. I mean, Crawford had the match won. Referee gets knocked down. Stomper goes to work with his boot, and that's that. Anyway, the Stomper, boy, don't ever underrate him. Tough guy, and he had a running feud with Stu Hart and his family. And we're going to take a look at Stomper in action against one of the Harts, Brett.
Well, the main and final event. Boy, no love lost here. The Stomper, Archie Goldie, out of Carbon, Alberta, against Bret Hart of Calgary. Hart outweighed by some 18 pounds. And we're just at the beginning of the match as Hart goes after him in the corner. Referee is Hathaway. The Stomper is certainly one of the most menacing characters to ever hit this ring. Look at him hammer away, Bret Hart going after him. One fall, 1 hour. Bret Hart, longtime North American heavyweight champion. You might wonder where the belt is now. In essence, nobody knows. That is in the sense that Bad News Allen actually is the North American heavyweight champion. However, he has been suspended for 6 months. Now there's a bit of a quandary as to what the Wrestling Alliance will do about this, but surely it won't be held in abeyance for 6 months. There's a two count. Archie the Stomper Goldie. Bret Hart. Thank you. In the heavyweight division, the latest rankings, incidentally, show Bad News Allen as the number one contender, with the belt being held up, technically. Number one contender is Bad News. Number two is Hart. And number three is the Stomper. So you've got the two and three fighters in that ring right now. One chest. Hardly need to tell you that Hart really has been dominating here in the early going. He's had much the best of it. Trying to get him in position. There's a two count, that's all. Pulls him over again. One. Just one. Brett could wind up a little dizzy at that pace. One fall, 1 hour. And we're moving toward the 5 minute mark. Stomper trying to work his head out of there. Cannot do so, and it's Bret Hart up top.
Five minutes gone.
One fall, 1 hour, 5 minutes gone. The Stomper, Archie Goldie, and Bret Hart. Up those ropes now, something's got to give. Stomper did. We caught him, whoops! One, two, that's all. Some slam, bam action there. Stomper, despite all his claims, having some difficulty here in the early going. Now let's move to the 20-minute mark. And Bret Hart, after taking quite a pounding and getting cut wide open, has come back strong. The referee just had a collision with the main event fighters. And it's the sleeper hold being applied by Bret Hart, but Stomper has made it to the corner and they move on out of there. Hammering away at the Stomper in the corner, Hart has made just a great comeback and has had the crowd in an uproar. Now he's got the Stomper in the corner, and he's just wailing away at him.
Yellow card warning for Bret Hart.
Yellow card warning, he just won't quit. Oh, the referee got thrown across the ring, and there will be a disqualification, I am sure, immediately. Gonna wipe out the whole thing. Wipe out the whole thing. That's it. There's a disqualification. The sleeper on the Stomper. But the referee, Hathaway, quite rightly, shows the red card. The disqualification.
Mamma mia, what a wild affair. Well, it wound up as a double disqualification. As you know, Bret Hart went on to become a great star in wrestling internationally. He won titles like the World and Intercontinental Divisions. We want to show him in action now against another up-and-comer at that time, the Dynamite Kid. Their bouts, I thought, were nothing short of sensational. And here they are doing battle for the British Commonwealth mid-heavyweight crown.
The Dynamite Kid against Bret Hart. Dynamite won the first fall. And just moments ago, Bret Hart squared things via the abdominal stretch. Buffalo Bill Cody, the referee. In actuality, we're at the 34-minute mark. The time limit is 45. Two out of three with a 45-minute time limit. Now, if it's at all possible, depending on how long this one goes, we do want to show you some of the Big Daddy Ritter, Jake Roberts match. But this is such a good one, we're going to stay until its conclusion. It has been a ring-a-ding-dong dandy.
Not over yet.
The Dynamite Kid and Bret Hart.
Come on, Dynamite. Stick it out, Dynamite. Stick it out.
I don't know how I inherited this, but the old fishmonger, John Foley, somehow got a chair here in press row. We're at the 35-minute mark. John Foley, the man from Cesspool, England. 35 minutes gone. There's the abdominal. Can he make it stick? He may have him right here, right now. Oh. Well, I've got Dynamite out of a jam.
No, over with you, Doc. Don't worry.
Oh! Oh, what a collision. What a collision. They both beating the bell at nine. Drop kick close in and out goes Bret.
Hey.
The John Foley cheering section is right here.
Luke Stuggy's boy's getting the worst end of the stick now.
Now listen, your boy has had a much tougher time, John Foley, than you'll admit.
I don't want to be my boy.
Oh! See what I mean. See what I mean. Well, oh, out he goes. Just made it. Just made it. Dynamite almost missed the count. The neck breaker as he got him again. This has been and continues to be a very solid match. Dynamite Kid. Bret Hart, two out of three, 45-minute time limit, and we are nearing the 40-minute mark. We're at 38 minutes.
Big suplex. Dynamite managed to hang onto those ropes. Cover one, two, oh! I think you call that 2.5.
Kaneko score!
You know, you almost think when you see a match like this that maybe one of these programs we should clear the deck and show you only one match. Mind you, all our lights depended on length, but this one has got 39 minutes. The crowd cheering for Bret Hart. Both men looking weary. Small wonder they've traveled a long way.
His back's too strong for that one. He'll stick that out. Sting it out, Tom. Sting it out. Sting it out.
If there is strange audio on your set, do not adjust your set. It's merely the voice of John Foley. Which is about as welcome as static. We're at 40 minutes now. Two falls out of three. It's all square, one fall apiece. The Dynamite Kid, back from Australia after a month or more. Brett's got a cover. He does. One, two, oh! 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 I thought he had him. Boy, that hand for the third count was halfway down to the canvas. We've gone 41 minutes. Pulls him over! One! Just one! One! Two! Bret Hart is coming so close! Now he's getting a little upset! Three minutes remaining. Dynamite Kid, of course, in the preferred position. It's all squared, one fall apiece. And if Dynamite could stretch it out to regulation time, he would retain his belt. Right now, he appears to be in pretty good shape. Two and a half minutes remaining. Oh, a solid smash by Dynamite. Wow. We're running late in time in this show, but we can't break away from this fight. There's only 2 minutes remaining.
Come on.
2 minutes left. Look out, pulls him over. 1, 2, 3. Oh boy, that was so close. I have seen so many close counts in this one. Pile driver, can he pull him up? He can't pull him. Nope. 1:20 left. Pulls him over. We've got 1:05 left. 1 minute. 1 minute. Crowd yelling for Bret Hart to do his thing. He's got the abdomino. He's got the abdomino on him. 45 seconds left. He's got the abdomino. He's pouring on the pressure. He's pouring on the pressure. There's 35 seconds remaining. Dynamite won't let go. Just a minute. You did it. Foley did it. Foley rang that bell with 30 seconds left.
You know, they went nearly an hour until that despicable J.R. Foley slid in beside me, rang the bell, and the only result that could be declared was a draw. It was robbery. Still, you know, you look at the Dynamite Kid, and pound for pound, he was considered perhaps the best wrestler in the world. Here he is against Davey Boy Smith, the World Mid-Heavyweight title on the line, and it is one great match.
Here's a bout that has the crowd buzzing. This for the World Mid-Heavyweight belt. The challenger from Leeds, England, the 220-pound Davey Boy Smith. The champion from Liverpool, the Dynamite Kid, at 215 pounds. One fall, 1 hour. We've just gone past the 15-minute mark. And this has been the first relatively quiet moment in the fight. They have been flying. Tremendous speed exhibited by both Smith and the Kid. Kid with an elbow smash. Bangs in a couple of chops. Look out! Pulls him over. 1, 2, almost. Oh! It was so close, it shook Dynamite up. You could see the look of astonishment. Because he almost lost it right there. Excellent match. Davey Boy Smith, Dynamite Kid. Referee is Cedric Hathaway. Dynamite from Liverpool, as mentioned, managed by J.R. Foley, who hails from Cesspool, England. Look out, Smith gets in another one. Gonna drive him into the ropes. Watch now. Oh. With an elbow, really rattled his cage. Referee is down. Dynamite going after Davey Boy, throws him over the top. The referee didn't see it. Referee. Counting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. He's going to come in now. Whoops. Boy, what a great come-from-behind win there by Davey Boy Smith. He slipped behind Dynamite, back, suplexed him. Net result, world title was his. Now, later on, as you probably know, Dynamite Kid and Davey Boy Smith became the very famous British Bulldogs. Here they are against the Cuban Commandos, the international tag team title at stake.
And this is, I think, the match that everybody has come to see. It is the British Bulldogs, Davey Boy Smith and the Dynamite Kid, a combined weight of 476 pounds against the Cuban Commandos, Cuban Assassin, and Comrade Jerry Morrow. This is for the championship tag team belts. One fall, 1 hour time limit. The referee, Wayne Hart. Whoa!
Oh, I've just been waiting to see this match. This is going to be the highlight, probably, of my commentating career, because this match here is what I've been waiting to see.
The Commandos double-teaming Davey Boy Smith, and he goes for a big ride. 1, 2, whoa! Amazing strength by Davey Boy Smith. Oh, and Comrade Jerry Morrow gets involved in the action. It's 2-on-1 again. Dynamite Kid breaks things up.
Well, I really think that this should be disqualified. You had the Cuban Assassin was going on to beat the guy, and the other guy came running in the ring.
They had two men in the ring. And they still do. Look at Davey Boy go! What a move by Davey Boy Smith. Two with one blow, that big a headbutt. Bingo! Bulldogs have been in complete control. They want those championship belts. Here comes a pile driver. Whammo! There's the tag. In comes Davey Boy.
Well, I tell you, that was a tremendous pile driver. He came right down in his knock. And I tell you, I don't know how he's even in this match. But that's how tough the Cubans are.
Look out. We're going to see a power slam. 1, 2, and the Assassin got in there to help break things up.
Very smart team.
Jerry Morrow is going up top. He wants to come down on the Dynamite Kid, who gets out of the way. There's a pin over there with Dynamite, or rather, Davey Boy on top of the Cuban Assassin. Morrow grabs his belt. It gets grabbed back from him. And the Weasel has just grabbed those championship belts at ringside.
Definitely out of hand. The referee's confused. And I'll tell you, believe me, I'm confused too, because I don't know what's happening here.
Well, neither do the Cuban Commandos. And it looks like they're leaving the arena. The referee is counting them out.
They let these guys get away with everything. And all the Cubans did, they left the ring, and I think they left for the night.
It's all over. They got counted out outside the ring. The winners of the bout are the British Bulldogs.
Yes, I'm tempted to comment, block, 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 because the Commandos' dirt chicken ran out of there and were counted out. Jerry Moe,
a very fine singles performer. You're going to see why here. He's against Owen Hart, perhaps the most agile of the very talented Hart family, known around the world as a great technical and acrobatic performer. And here they are in battle for the North American heavyweight crown.
You know, I've got this North American belt in front of me. It's a fascinating old thing. The first North American heavyweight champion was William Muldoon back in 1884. And so far, the belt goes back.
A very, very precious belt. And while the action has been taking place in the ring, there's been a real tug-of-war at ringside between Bruce Hart and the Cuban Assassin, handcuffed to each other at the side of the ring to make sure that the Cuban does not interfere on behalf of Jerry Moe.
Now we got a chunk of Owen Hart right here on our table.
Hung up in the
ropes. Owen Hart in all kinds of trouble. He's hung up. Referee Rod Hayter trying to open up the ropes to free the champion.
Couldn't pull him down.
Sleeper.
Yes, sir. Sweeper.
Champion Jerry Moe says he's got it all. He's got the good looks. He's got the champagne. He's got the women. All he needs is that belt, and he's close, very, very close to winning that North American heavyweight title from champion Owen Hart.
We're just past the 10-minute mark. I mentioned a moment ago the name William Muldoon from 1884. There are such other great names. Strangler Ed Lewis, Jim Landis, Lou Thesz, Bronco Nagurski, Antonio Rocca, Killer Kowalski, Von Gagne, Pat O'Connor. It's an historic belt, and that's what Jerry Moe would like to be wearing.
You're right. To be a member of that elite group is like being in the Wrestling Hall of Fame.
The more spectacular wrestlers to come out of the Hart Brothers pro wrestling camp. They trained young men in Western Canada to move in a pro wrestling match. And Owen chose one of his moves right there. Other graduates include the British Bulldogs, Brett Bruce and Keith Hart, Ricky Martel, Billy Jack, Junkyard Dog, Jake the Snake, Roberts, the list goes on and on. Okay, we're moving toward the 15-minute mark. Jerry Moe making a spirited challenge. Owen Hart could be in a little difficulty.
It's a determined bid by Jerry Moe. I'm surprised to see him showing this well. And as yet, the Cuban Assassin has not been able to get in and interfere thanks to being handcuffed to Bruce Hart, Owen's brother, at ringside. Ooh, the big neck breaker. Jerry Moe.
Guess two, he thought he had him for a moment. The crowd held its collective breath.
And Moe was not pleased about the speed of referee Rod Hayter's count. He thought he should already be doing his chicken strut wearing this North American heavyweight championship belt. It was not to be. Jerry Moe exerting all kinds of force, bending Owen Hart into a human pretzel.
start staggering. Caught one in the midsection. Boy, he needs a rally. Oh, close again. There would be no living with Jerry Morrow if he grabbed off that belt.
Even without the belt, I would suspect it would be impossible to live with the guy.
On hard against Jerry Morrow. One fall, 60 minutes. We're moving toward the 15-minute mark.
Look at the strength of Owen Hart. He broke the hold but got a knee in the back in return. Big headbutt. Champagne Jerry Moore, one of the hardest heads in all of wrestling.
One, two, again, Hart hanging on. Let's go.
A spirited comeback by Owen Hart. Power slam. Whammo.
Why did he slam him?
And I was surprised to see Morrow slip out before the three count. Big suplex.
One, two, again. Morrow slipped away.
Minutes,
John.
15 minutes.
At the 15-minute mark, holds him over. Hart suddenly taking over control of things.
And Morrow looks groggy, but whoa! He came up with that big knee right to the chops of Owen Hart. Superflex.
Beautiful suplex off the top.
Oh, back to Allen. Interferes.
Allen tripped him. He dropped something. Small package. He got it. Owen Hart did.
Owen Hart retains the championship.
Bad News Allen tried to mess it up, but justice prevailed and Owen got the decision, no question. Now, Owen's brother, Bruce, also was a very successful singles and tag team performer. At one point in his career, he teamed up with Brian Pillman. They called the duo Bad Company, and they held the international tag team belts for over a year. Here they are against the combination of Rip Rogers and Kerry Brown.
As we move toward the 15-minute mark, good clothesline. Here's Brian Pillman facing Rip Rogers. He says, Ripper, I want you. Goes after him in the corner. Bangs away. Caught him beautifully high on the shoulder. Then a drop kick from close range. And Pillman showing his great speed. And there's a little bit of strength as well. And another slam. What a show.
Well, now you know why they call him Flying Brian Pillman. He does a little noggin knocking. Kerry Lee Brown down and almost out. Scrambles out of the ring. Pillman in complete control. And now he's going Air Express.
He's taking a long time. Oh, my. Oh, did he catch Rogers? Oh.
15 minutes gone.
Rogers was really shaken up. Small wonder. We're at the 15-minute mark. Pillman going up top to fly again. What do we got here? It's been a long time coming. Caught him, splashed him. again, Brown breaks it up. They can't make it stick.
Well, Kerry Brown had to get involved, otherwise his partner, Rip Rogers, would have been down for the three count. Rogers on Strain Street, and he just crawls over to make the tag with Kerry Lee Brown, who now is delivering elbows. This team of Brown and Rogers were in all kinds of trouble earlier. I counted two significant pins by Bad Company, during which the referee was distracted. Look at that. Pillman was thrown over the top rope by Kerry Lee Brown. That would have been a disqualification. Another reason to have Bad Company retain their championship. But the referee, Jonathan Holliday, did not see it.
Pillman recovering slowly from off the deck. Some of the fans telling Mr. Holliday that an eye examination might not be a bad idea. There's the toss. Rogers covering. 1-2, that's off. They're going to do a little double whammy. Now Kerry Brown all set to go. Knee drop to the side of the head. 1-2. Whoa.
That was 2 3/4, and Kerry Brown is complaining about the speed of the count. Personally, I think Jonathan Holliday employs a fast count as a referee. Look at that big clothesline. Pillman has been shaken up ever since he hit the concrete after going out over the top rope, and the team of the Midnight Cowboys has been ready to take advantage of his weakened condition. Here it is again, another double whammy.
Well, I wonder when you see a yellow card for something like that. 1-2, that's all. Rogers is enraged. He insists that was a three count. He's certainly vocal in that ring. Pillman, very much in need of a tag in the corner. Can't pull it off, and Kerry Brown comes in. Nearing the 20-minute mark. Tag team title bout, Bad Company against the Midnight Cowboys. Oh, did he get up there? Got him doubled, one. Oh, was that beautiful.
Brian Pillman trying for the impossible to pin two men at the same time. He did, however, come close, but he still remains badly shaken up and in need of a tag, and Rip Rogers has him hung up on that rope. He's going to try for the old superplex off that second rope. There it is. Pillman looks dazed.
But so does Rogers. Rogers, in coming down, hit the back of his head. So he cannot take advantage of the situation at the moment. But now Rogers, although he's staggering, goes up to the top. Oh, he fell on the ropes. He lost his balance because Bruce Hart had been wiggling the ropes. Can Pillman get over to make the tag? That is the question.
Well, both men are badly shaken up inside the ring. They both are in need of making a tag. Pillman desperately going towards his corner, and he does make the tag with Bruce Hart. Look at this move. Here comes that flying clothesline. That looks like it. 2-3. It is all over. That flying clothesline by Bruce Hart. A great maneuver after that tag by Brian Pillman. Whoa, a great ending to the match.
Man, what a hard-fought affair, and what a great clothesline by Bruce Hart to gain the decision. Now, you know, Bruce also had an alliance with Davey Boy Smith, and here they are for the International Tag Team belts against the combination of Kerry Brown and Duke Myers, appropriately known as the Masters of Disaster.
The International Tag Team belts are on the line. The referee not looking, and a low blow by Kerry Brown. Hart comes in to join him. I haven't even been able to tell you yet who's in this fight. It's Davey Boy Smith and Bruce Hart, the challengers, against Kerry Brown and Duke Myers, the international tag team champions. One fall with a 1 hour time limit, and yes, the belts are on the line. I would say, and we're past the 10-minute mark, that the fight has been dominated by Bruce Hart and Davey Boy Smith. They have been terrific. However, oh, knee drop to the side of the head. Brown very proud of himself. There's a count one. He got something in his trunks. He reaches and he bangs him. There was no tag. Duke Myers goes in. Myers, 279 and a half pounds, out of Portland, Oregon. Brown at 250, and the lighter ones are Smith and Hart. Smith at 218, Hart at 216. Referee Hathaway, one fall, 1 hour. Off those ropes, something's got to give here. Big elbow to the chest. The tag, and it's Kerry Brown. Smith has got to make a tag. The way things are going, is he going to drop him? Oh, that shoulder. Ouch. Cocky Kerry Brown. Number one, two, just. Well, Davey Boy Smith is down, but he's not out. Up those ropes. Oh, man, they collided. Both of them down. Can Davey Boy get over to make the tag? He's working his way over. He's stopped. For the International Tag Team Championship belts, Duke Myers and Kerry Brown against Bruce Hart and Davey Boy Smith. Smith trying to get over for that tag. One. Oh, did he get banged out of there by Bruce Hart? He does. The referee didn't see it. The referee didn't see it. What do you want to bet? Duke Myers had him distracted. I told you. Smith gets thrown over the top, but he landed on his feet. We're coming up to the 15-minute mark. We're at the 15-minute mark. Bruce Hart pouring around that ring now. Goes after Kerry Brown. Hammering away. Has he got him in trouble? A little head knocking. start in the corner. Look out! Oh, he ran Myers into the post or into the turnbuckle. Brown against Hart. It's the tag. Brown did not see it. Clothesline off the top. Where's Hathaway? Where's Hathaway? Look at Dana White. Oh, man. Smith and Hart had the fight. They had it won. But now it's a mess. Dana White and Gala come in. Judah Rosenblum, where's the rest of them? By these guys, and there's nobody else on the premises. I spoke to his son. Here they come. He's been rattling. He's got Kingsley. He knocks Rosenblum down. Over on the other side. Look at this. Gamazzo in that ring, hammering away at each other. Brown and Myers were disqualified, and it eventually wound up a wild eight-man brawl. Let's move ahead now to another fine Hart combination, Keith and Bret Hart. They go into action against an unusual combo, Sweet William and Crazy Nick Carter, known as the Kiwis, later in their careers to become the Bushwhackers. Here it is, it's wild and it's woolly.
We got us a barn burner going here, the Kiwis. That not-so-dynamic duo from out of New Zealand against the fine brother combination of Keith and Bret Hart. This is one fall with a 45-minute time limit, and we're nearing the 17-minute mark. Oh, it's been wild. The Kiwis, Crazy Nick and Sweet William, as they call them. Stopped a fist with his nose, and he's bleeding from that nose. Well, I'll tell you, this is a wild affair. Good kick, got it beautifully. Bret Hart with a desperation drop kick. Here's Crazy Nick. Well, it's all Kiwis at this point in the match. Hart is going to have to get over to make the tag. It's Sweet William. Quick. Not quite. Could not make the tag. Well, he's got to make that tag. He made it, but did the referee see it? The referee didn't see it. Oh, the crowd is wild. to mete out the punishment. Oh, this crowd is really something else. You're watching the Kiwis from New Zealand against the Hart Boys from Calgary. And it looks like a shootout at the old OK Corral, doesn't it? Brett has got to make a tag. Up those ropes. Manages to keep him down. Cover one, two, and that's all. Well, this crowd is totally on fire. Well, Sweet William gets a free shot. Oh, wrong number. How sweet it is. He got Nick Carter. There's the tag. Keith Hart coming in. Hits him with a drop kick. Knocks the other man down. Comes piling in a Sweet William. Look at him go to work now. He's got Crazy Nick in the opposite corner. Bret Hart joining the party. And the crowd going out of its skull. Ooh-wee! Keith Hart is in there legally. We're going to do it again. Ooh, they're going to do it in stereo. Hey! Keith Hart, oh, and again! Both of them go down. It's supposed to be Keith Hart against Sweet William. Off those ropes. Oh, he caught him in the throat. Caught him in the throat. Tag, and it's Crazy Nick. Sweet William. One, two, not quite. Keith hanging on. Now he's going to come off the top. He's going to splash. Whoops. Look out! He's gonna turn him for the Boston Crab! He's got him in the crab! Brett is holding the tree! What's this? Crazy Nick hit him! Nick hit him! The referee didn't see it! Cover one, two, three! Oh no! Oh no! A totally illegal move by Crazy Nick! And as a result, the Kiwis get the win over the Hart Boys.
Would you believe it? Crazy Nick got away with it, used a foreign object, controversial decision, oh my. Anyway, let's look at Jim Neidhart. Later in his career, he would team with Bret Hart to become the Hart Foundation, but a great singles performer, a battle of the heavyweights here, Neidhart against Neil Gay.
Well, let us feast the old peepers on a couple of heavies, and I do mean Neil Gay out of Montreal. He bends those old beams at 295 against Jim Neidhart, a very solid 282. This is one fall, 20-minute time limit, and we're right off the top. We're picking it up from the beginning. Away we go. Neidhart, the man with the enormous strength. at this point in time, not quite sure where he's going to be playing his football this season. It could be with the Dallas Cowboys if he can smash his way into that lineup. Plays along the defensive line. Neil Gay, big chunk of man, also a possessor of very solid strength. And as I mentioned, this is one fall, and there's a 20-minute time limit. That's Neidhart, the victim of the hammerlock at the moment. No, not a hammerlock. He's got an arm bar going on him. Manages to get in a right-hand shot. Referee is Wainhart. One fall, 20 minutes. Look at Neidhart. Look at that power cover. And it's a one, and it's a two. That's it. I have the feeling that Neil Gay got a haircut. What do you think? He had long locks last week. Look at him now. Well, it's good news that Jake Roberts might be missing for only another couple of weeks. Sakurada later in the show, if we have time to get to it, we'll be tangling with Hercules Ayala. Look out! Oh! Oh, there old Ring moved a foot. One, two, that's all. Look at that for power. One, two, that's all again. He cannot quite get the pin on him. Neil Gay, Jim Neidhart. Neidhart also has concentrated in the past on track and field, and primarily the shot put, where he established college records south of the border. And the takedown by the Trunks, and Mr. Gay claiming innocence. Solid right, he comes in with another one. Wham, bam! There's the cover, and it's a one, and it's a two, and that's all. That's all. Slugfest down on their knees. Off those ropes. Got him coming in. Neil Gay and Jim Neidhart. Right now, Neil pitching and Neidhart catching. He's going to drive him. No, he dropped the shoulder on the knee and cover. One, two, just two. One, two, just two. He's using the trunks for a little bit of leverage. Neidhart just continues to hang on. He's going to drop him. Oh, that's a little hard on the back. Rolls for a minute to cover, and it's a one. That's all. Give Neidhart an E for effort. He's managing to hang on. Well, watch out for this one. Hold him down. Got inside him. One, two, three. Got him. Oh, how about that? Quick move by Neidhart. And there's your winner, young Jim Neidhart, scoring over Neil Gay.
Jim Neidhart, very quick for a big man, and he scores the win. Now I want you to look at a couple of internationally acclaimed fighters. Jake Roberts, later be known as Jake the Snake, and also Big Daddy Ritter, to become perhaps more well known as the Junkyard Dog. They're here battling it out in Stampede Wrestling for the North American Heavyweight Crown.
And here it is, the main event. Jake Roberts, the Louisiana locomotive in there. 275-pounder against the 300-pound Big Daddy Ritter of Nashville, Tennessee. Non-title bout, but a very important scrap for both men. Because at the end of the rainbow, a shot with Harley Race, the world heavyweight champion. Ritter, the former North American title holder. Jake Roberts, the current king. And Jake won that crown from Ritter in this ring. Referee is Sandy Scott. It's one fall with a one-hour time limit. And we've got about 11 minutes now. That's Ritter up top. Roberts down on the deck, but Roberts gets to his feet. I would say if you were scoring this fight on points up to the present, that Roberts would have enjoyed a wide lead. But just as we hit the television screen, Big Daddy Ritter began to come on. Tough night for John Foley thus far, with Dynamite Kid losing. And with the opening 10 minutes, he had to suffer through the fact that Ritter was outclassed by Roberts. But now, Ritter is coming back.
Come on, Roberts!
Roberts dying to punch him out. There's the takedown. Ritter being warned about use of the hair. Breaks the hold momentarily. One fall, 60 minutes. Roberts working his way up. Seventh bout on the card tonight. Showed you some of the action in five of them. Roberts, a little trouble. Did Ritter load up that glove? The crowd over the other side, a little upset by something that Ritter has pulled here. He banged Roberts on the shoulder. Goes after that shoulder. And the question is, did he load up the glove? Roberts is in difficulty. Pointing at that shoulder. Oh, Nelly. problem with that shoulder. Can he hang on? Whoops, he went over the top instead of the shoulder block. There's a miss. Roberts starting to come on now. Bottom coming in. But that shoulder is bothering him desperately. The crowd in a real uproar. Shot to the midsection and another one. Cover, 1, 2. Well, just about 1 3/4. Crowd yelling for the sleeper. There's a shot to the midsection. Werner with that big bandage. Oh, he hurt his wrist. He hurt his wrist stopping that fist. Now he's taking something out of that bandage. I don't know. He's got a chair. Grabs that chair, goes into the ring, bangs him on top of the head. And they're going to have to wipe this whole thing out. Roberts wants a shot, knocks down the referee, and that's going to be that. And they wipe it out.
I think maybe you can understand why Jake Roberts went absolutely berserk, and unfortunately, he was disqualified. Now, a great guest at the Calgary Stampede way back when was the eighth wonder of the world, the late, great Andre the Giant. Here, he is featured in a battle royal. It's rare footage, and you're going to have a treat watching Andre in action.
Now you're going to see something very unusual. A 13-man Wrestle Royal. I'm going to have eyes in the back of my head, and so are you, to figure out who is fighting who and what is what. $5,000 on the line. Andre the Giant will be the focus of attention. Barabbas and Hercules Ayala both tried to take him out. Isn't he huge? 7'6", 483 pounds, and he will be the focal point of attention. Everybody else is fighting everybody else, and the rules of this thing are he wants to get Big Daddy Ritter. The referee is Sandy Scott outside the ring, Jackson inside the ring. There's three guys going after Andre. Now just a minute, we almost lost Barabbas. Andre being slugged by Ayala, and he's got Hito and Sakurada hanging on to him. Morrow comes in to join the fray. They're trying to lift him out over the top. They figure he's probably the toughest adversary in there. He's wrapped up in those ropes, Andre. Andre is having to fight two or three at once. Ayala is almost over the top. Nope, manages to hold out. Well, this is mayhem, is it not? Looks like Saturday night in a few local bars I've seen. Oh, yes. Is anybody gone? I can't figure out. I don't see anybody missing. Ritter's getting clobbered by Gallant. Big headbutt by Andre knocks Sakurada down. And Andre's back in control of things. Andre has never been beaten. He decides to squeeze Barabbas into the corner. And he squeezes Sakurada. Look at the size of him. He's got them squeezed into that corner. Huge man. corner. Andre's got a ball. Go! Got them all jammed in there. Andre the Giant. The big focal point of attention. Enormous size, enormous strength. There's nobody has run out as yet that I am aware of. Andre against Hercules.
I wonder who's going to pick this up.
He's got, how much have you got in the pot, Stu?
$2,000.
$2,000. Okay, we'll get that. Right, Jerry Morrow is up on the back of Andre. Up goes Morrow. That's the end of him. He's out of it. Out of contention. Ayala goes after Andre in the corner, and he's slamming him in that corner. Sakurada trying to lift him up. Terry Sawyer, in the meantime, is having quite a brawl with Big Daddy Ritter. Everybody's scrambling after everybody. Sakurada gets decked. The guy who is causing the biggest commotion, the guy everybody's kind of watching for, well, you know who it is. He wanted to get Big Daddy Ritter. Ritter climbed out of there. Is almost out. Barabbas. The ranks are thinning. Barabbas and Morrow are out. Okay, we're nearing the 5-minute mark. This is a battle to the finish. The last one in the ring takes the 2,000. I want you to notice Andre against Hercules Ayala in the corner. Ayala is 300 pounds. He looks like a midget, doesn't he? Terry Sawyer just got tossed out when I wasn't looking. Up goes Duke Savage. He's out of there. Keith Hart is out of there. Okay, our numbers are thinning, to say the least. Duke Savage got really rattled as he went out, too. So now we've got Sakurada, Hedo, Bruce Hart. Correct that. We haven't got Bruce Hart anymore. He's out of there. Is Ayala out? I didn't see him. Larry Lane against Andre. Sakurada trying to sneak around behind Andre. Out goes Gallant. Now we're down. Sakurada, Hedo, and Ritter against Andre. The three of them attempting to go against Andre. They gang up on him now. Three of them against Andre. Ritter gives him a shot. Gives him another shot. They're jamming him in that corner. Headbutt to the neck. Try to get rid of Andre. Very seldom Andre is off his feet. Andre trying to hang on. Caught Ritter. Then he knocks down the two Japanese wrestlers. He wants Ritter. I think Ritter just gave up. Ritter just gave up. He ran out, went over the top. So now it's Hedo and Sakurada against Andre. They're trying to do something about it. Isn't he awesome? Sakurada's 280 pounds worth. These two Japanese guys are tough. Sakurada trying to come. What power? Does it make any difference? Andre totally in control. No, well, really, when the chips are down, I was going to say he's totally in control. Got to give it to Hito and Sakurada. They're hanging in there. Hito at 260, Sakurada at 280. That combination outweighs Andre by about 60 pounds. But Andre is one. Just one 483 pounder. Can they lift him over the top? Oh, Chansey. We've got 9 minutes. Andre with a big hit back to Sakurada. Still hard, the Japanese boys are managing to stay in surprisingly long.
I never saw such strength and such power in my life as that.
Goodbye, Sakurada. It's now Hito. Now Hito against Andre. I don't know. If he heads for those ropes, Hito could be gone. Instead, he squeezes him in the corner. We're at the 10-minute mark.
Andre the Giant with a memorable performance there. Well, we hope you have enjoyed our little stroll down memory lane. We've been delighted to bring to you some of the certified classics of Stampede Wrestling of yesteryear. If you have any comments or inquiries about Stampede Wrestling or the stars, please drop us a line to Stampede Wrestling Classics, Post Office Box 33002, 3919 Richmond Road, Southwest, Calgary, Alberta, Canada, T3E7E2. In the meantime, and in between time, that's it. Another edition of Stampede Wrestling. Bye now.